work. So, let's make sure we're good. Show me gameplay. Come on. Good, 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 good. All right. So today, what we're going to try and do is we're going to head to the Dust District, and there is a certain logic puzzle. And, yeah, we're going to try and figure out this puzzle, even though what I've learned... Positive relation. Got it. So anyway, what I've learned is that this puzzle, it changes. Like, it's never the same solution every time, which makes it even harder. So what we're going to try and do is solve it. And I've got my grid up, which I've pulled from online. It's got all the listings of the possibilities. We're going to solve the puzzle. And we're going to get the achievement. Now, what I'm hoping is I can solve it, head back out to the Dust District, start collecting shit, all that fun crap. If it doesn't happen, what I'm going to do is I'm going to save before the door. And then, if it doesn't let me back out once I get to the next section, which will basically just be like a...
This was once my world. All things from the northernmost shores to here, Karnaca in the south.
Yeah, Karnaca and stuff. Anyway, so, what was I saying? I'm going to save before the door. If I can't get back out, then I'm just going to load the save, go through the Dust District and all that. Because mostly what I want to do is just get this fucking achievement out of the way. Because I just looked at it, and it's a pain in the fucking ass. Like, I cannot lie. It is such a pain in the ass.
From the Duke. We're losing too many people. Someone shooting at us!
What was that?
It's heavy right there!
Who is?
Let me demonstrate all for you.
And dead. Alright. Round two. And dead. Ah, good times. Alright. So let's see if we can solve that puzzle once we get in here. Anything you got? Not really. Goodbye! I wish they threw farther. Like, I think the throwing could have been a lot better in this game. Like, don't get me wrong, it's supposed to be based on some bit of physics, at least in this part. But when you throw somebody and you're aiming up, you want them to go flying outward, and it's just like, nah, they're just falling. Okay, fine. So, alright. Looks like we got a lot of junk over there. We want to get that rune eventually. Just want to make sure we don't miss any safes. Generator got me. So. Now, luckily, I do like a good puzzle, but it has to be a good puzzle.
Silver dust out of my ears. All apples and slit.
Oh shit, he moved.
Damn you.
Well, that was unfortunate. He stood right on top of me with that grenade. And now there's a dust storm, which just makes it harder for them to see, harder to hear, all that fun stuff. So I can basically move around without worrying too much. Mine collapses. Numerous casualties. It was just a Tuesday. And again, these small details, like these advertisements on these buildings, I really enjoy. Like, don't get me wrong. Like, it's so easy just to do, like, a non-textured, no-advertised building. Just nothing on the wall, just blank wall with dust. But they went and took the extra effort, and they're like, hey, we're gonna create a fucking cityscape. Let's do it. And it's awesome. I love it. I'll take that rewire tool. Thank you. So now it works for me. Perfect. Wow. I got hit a lot at the same time. Now that's one part of this game I don't necessarily like is... So when you get hit by anything, your whole fucking screen just instantly goes red. Just completely red. Like, it doesn't matter if, like, it stubbed your toe, you fell the wrong way, like, it just goes super red. And it makes it very difficult to see. Don't get me wrong, I'm okay with that to a certain respect, because I'm like, alright, it indicates that you took damage, that's nice, all that fun crap, but when you're that red, that early, and you're not, like, bleeding out of every orifice, it's a little distracting. I can get up here now. Before I couldn't, but now I can. Let me see. Ah!
And the Viper. Hello, Emily. Stilton's home is... I've been doing reconnaissance. Talking to people. The Overseers and the Howlers have divided up the district. Just ahead is neutral territory where no one will harass you. But further on, the Howlers and the Overseers both have boundaries set up. And beyond those points, they'll attack you on sight.
Aramis Stilton is the real goal. Sokolov said you had an idea.
Yes. I believe that if you take out Paolo or Vice Overseer Byrne, the other one will grant you safe passage and will help you get inside Stilton's home. Neutralize either one of them and bring him to the other.
What else do you know that might help me?
Byrne is protected by the Overseers. Paolo has the Howlers, but I think he's also got some kind of black magic charm. They say he's got to die twice before the sun sets. Or he can't be killed. Good luck with that.
Got to die, they say. Oh, wow. Well, my download completed. Hopefully nobody saw that, but if you did, yeah, that'll be what we're doing on next. If it was blurred, fine. Sirkona's finest, never handed the crown, blah 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 blah. Betting encouraged. There we go. There's my inn. How many runes do I got? 3? Okay, that's not bad. Doppelganger and Domino, I just don't like that combo. Actually, let me look at dark vision real quick. What are the other ones? Greater dark vision. See objects and security systems through walls, visualize enemy routes, and their current destination. That's not bad per se, but I just... Always throw closest living thing, use it to avoid a group of enemies who will be unaware of what's happening around them, or use it in combat enthralling enemies and making them vulnerable to your attacks. Throw objects farther. Well, that's exactly the thing I was talking about before. Alright, let's do it. Break down weaker wood doors with your sword. Alright, I'm good with that. Yes. Stronger than yesterday.
Jimmy's sister says you can beat any lock in the city. I'm not sure why Stilton's house needed to be shut up tight like this, but what do you think? Can you crack it?
Give me a minute.
Durante knows how to get in here. Paolo had him feeding old Stilton or watching him.
All right, so.
Pay him off for the secret.
Here's the trick. New save.
Durante got beat down by the overseers and taken away.
Never mind. Maybe another time.
Or not. Let's go.
After a dinner party where Lady Winslow, Dr. Mercola, Countess Conti, Madame Nassau, and Baroness Finch. The women sat in a row. They all wore different colors, and Madame Nassau wore a jaunty blue hat. Well, Madame Nassau wore a blue hat. Okay. Baroness Finch was at the far left. Baroness Finch, far left. Next to the guest room, wearing a purple jacket. Next to the guest wearing a purple jacket. So the person on the left was wearing the purple jacket. So I have to figure out who that person is. All right, fine. The lady in white sat left of someone in green. I remember that white outfit because the woman spilled her whiskey all over it. So the woman in white had whiskey. Traveler from Debonkva was dressed entirely in red. Debonkva red. One of the dinner guests bragged about her bird pendant. The woman next to her said they were finer in Debonkva. Bird Pendant is next to Debonkva, so Debonkva cannot be Bird Pendant. Okay. Where she lived. So Lady Winslow showed off her prized war medal. So Lady Winslow has the war medal. Nobody else has the war medal. At which the lady from Karnaca scoffed. So Lady Winslow is not the woman from Karnaca. Saying it was no match for her diamond. So the woman from Karnaca has the diamond. Okay. Someone else carried a valuable ring. And when she saw it, the visitor from Balton next to her almost spilled her neighbor's absinthe. So Balton does not have the ring and does not have absinthe. No ring. No absinthe. Okay. Dr. Marcola raised her rum in toast. So Marcola has the rum. Rum, rum, rum. Ah, I like this chart. It's a good chart. Okay. The lady from Freyport, full of beer, jumped onto the table. Freyport has a beer. Okay. Correlations are getting ever smaller and smaller. Let's see. Falling onto the guest in the center seat. So she is not the guest in the center seat. Freyport is not the center. Spilling the poor woman's wine. So, center seat has wine. Again, I know this is a lot of bullshit. Don't get me wrong. I know it. But they make this puzzle a pain in the ass, and with a different solution each time, it's like, ah! Then Countess Contney captivated them all with a story about her wild youth in Dunwall. So, Conti is from Dunwall. We're solving it as quickly as we can here. Looking for blank spaces in my sheet. You have to knock out possibilities, but I don't see one yet. Not a simple one. In the morning, there were four heirlooms under the table. the bird pendant, snuff tin, the diamond, and the ring. Under the table. Finch. Okay, let me go through the list again. Sat in a row. They wore different colors. Madame Nassau wore a jaunty blue hat. Baroness Finch was at the far left, next to the guest wearing a purple jacket. Baroness Finch was not wearing a purple jacket, so Baroness Finch was not wearing purple. The lady in white sat next to someone in green, or sat left of someone in green. Lady in white sat left of someone in green, so she could not have been the far right. Lady in white could not be on the far right. And again, it's going to take some time, but we will get this puzzle. Is that left of someone in green? What do you mean? That green... the far left. Let me see. All right. Lady in white sat left of someone in green. So lady in white is on the left side of green. Green not be on the far left. So that only leaves two possibilities. Red is on the far left. Could not be on the far right. I remember that the white outfit because the woman spilled her whiskey all over it. The woman in white has the whiskey, right? We got that. Traveler and was entirely in red. Debunkva was red. Bragged about her bird pendant. The woman next to her said they were finer in Debunkva. Bragged about her bird pendant. Do we know who the bird pendant was for? No. But she was next to Debunkva. Does that help us? What does that mean? That Debunkva could not be the bird pendant? But I already got that. Debunkva could not be the bird pendant. And Lady Winslow is not Debunkva. Okay, hold on. Wait. No, that's not right. Okay. She could still be. Lady Winslow couldn't be the woman next to DeBongva because she has the bird pendant. Okay. Lady Winslow showed off her war medal, at which the lady from Karnaca scoffed, saying it was no match for her diamond. I'm very close on some of these. If I can figure it out, I can get it. Like, if I can figure out if Baroness Finch is red or white, I can pretty much solve a lot of these here. Or if Freyport was Madame Nassau or Lady Winslow. Someone else carried a valuable ring. Visitor from Baleton. Did not have the ring. Where is the linking point here? Raised her rum in toast. Marcola had rum. Which I got. Where's the most correlation happening here? I'm missing part of this. Where is it at? Someone else carried a valuable ring when she saw it. Toast. Lady from Freyport, full of beer, jumped onto the table, falling onto the guest in the center seat, spilling the poor woman's wine, with a story about her wild youth in Dunwall. The bird pendant, snuff tin, the diamond, and the ring. But the war medal by Lady Winslow was not there. Who owned each? Who owned each? Almost spilled on her neighbor's absinthe. What am I missing? After? The women sat in a row. They all wore different colors. Madame Nassau wore a jaunty blue hat. Baroness Finch was at the far left. Baroness Finch was at the far left. Okay, here's my correlation. All right, Baroness Finch was at the far left. And the far left could not have the war medal. So Baroness Finch could not have the war medal. Baroness Finch. War medal. Right. We knew that. Okay. Fine. How does that correlate? I mean, I could basically just guess, but at the same time, do I want to do that? Next to the guest wearing a purple jacket. Okay, so purple jacket has to be on the left. Okay, got it. All right, purple left. Does that help me? Not quite, but we're getting there. That was a little bit more helpful. Lady in white sat left of someone in green. Could not be far right, could not be far left. Green is not left. Okay. So, all right, the lady in white sat left of someone in green, and green cannot be left or far left, which means white cannot be far left, which means green is in the center. Okay, we've got this so far. All right, pretty good, pretty good. So green is either Lady Winslow or Countess Conti. Okay. All right, we're getting this. Is that the left of someone in green? Remember the white outfit because the woman spilled her whiskey all over it. White was whiskey. That's not really important. We want to know the positions. The traveler was dressed entirely in red. When someone at dinner guest bragged about the bird pendant, the woman next to her said they were finer and debonkva. So bird pendant. Do we know who has that yet? We do not. Bird pendant cannot be left or far left. At the same time, bird pendant cannot be left or far left, but somebody next to her. Debonkva next to her. No, something's wrong then. How can she be far left? I messed up somewhere. Where did I get that DeBonkville was on the far left? Where she lived. At which the lady from Karnaca scoffed, saying it was no match for her diamonds. Someone else carried a valuable ring when she saw the visitor from Bailton. Next to her, almost spilled her neighbor's absinthe. So the ring could be the absinthe, but we don't know for sure. Almost spilled her neighbor's absinthe. No, okay, so the visitor from Bailton. Yeah. Bailton. You're either in the center or on the right. All right, let's just make a guess here. So we have to know the location. On the left. Finch. If I don't get it right now, I'm just gonna reset the puzzle and then we'll do it again. I know it's a pain in the butt, but we're gonna get it. Conti was on the right. Finch, Marcola, Winslow, Conti, not Sal. The diamond. Yeah, something's wrong. I need to reset this. Something went terribly wrong. We'll figure it out. I made a relations choice somewhere. I knew it was wrong the second I saw there was an error. So, alright. Well, I'll get this. Alright, hang on. Hang on. Hold on. Hold on just a bit. Woman sat in the row. They were all over different colors. Not Sal, wore a jaunty blue hat. Not Sal and blue. Fine. Fairness Finch was at the far left. So at the far left was Miss Finch. We know that. She has to be far left. Next to the guest wearing the purple jacket. So the guest on the left was wearing purple. The lady in white sat left of someone in green. So the lady in white cannot be on the far right. She has to sit on the left. At the same time, the lady in green could not be on the far left because she has to be on the right. Fine. I remember that white outfit because the woman spilled her whiskey all over it. The white outfit had whiskey. White whiskey. Whiskey white. The lady in white sat left of someone in green. Right. I remember it because the woman in white spilled her whiskey all over it. The traveler from Debakva was dressed entirely in red. So Debakva in red. Has bragged about her bird pendant. The woman next to her said they were finer in Debakva. So Debakva could not be the bird pendant. Debakva could not be the bird pendant. She was next to the lady with the bird pendant. Lady Winslow showed off her prize, war medal. Lady Winslow has that war medal. Has it. At which the lady from Karnaca scoffed, saying it was no match for her diamond. So Karnaca has the diamond. Right. Okay. We're doing good so far. Someone else carried a valuable ring. And when she saw it, the visitor from Baelton next to her almost spilled her neighbor's absinthe. So Baelton does not have the ring and does not have absinthe. No ring. No ring, no absinthe. Dr. Marcola raised her rum and toast. Marcola had the rum. Lady from Freyport. Freyport full of beer. Jumped onto the table, falling onto the guest in the center seat. So Freyport was not the center seat. Spilling the poor woman's wine. So Freyport also did not have wine. We knew that, though. She had the beer. But she was... the woman in the center seat had wine. Center seat had the wine. Countess Conti captivated them all with a story of her wild youth in Dunwall. Conti was from Dunwall. In the morning, there were four heirlooms. The bird, pendant, snuff tin, the diamond, and the ring. Who owned each? Dinner party. The women sat in a row. They all wore different colors. Madame Sal wore a jaunty blue hat. Baroness Finch was at the far left, next to the guest wearing a purple jacket. Guest in purple was on the left. Lady in white sat left of someone in green. Lady of White sat next to someone in green. Green cannot be far left or left, which means White cannot be far left because she sat next to the woman in green. So if the lady in white was on the right-hand side, Lady in white sat left of someone in green, and the woman in green was on the far right. Yes, that checks out. So the woman in purple was on the left. The woman in red was on the far left. The woman in green was on the far right. The woman in white was on the right. Okay, we're getting there. We're getting there. I remember that because the woman in the white outfit spilled her whiskey all over it. I need to know positions. Traveler from Debonkva was dressed entirely in red. When one of the dinner guests bragged about her bird pendant, the woman next to her said they were finer in Debonkva. So the woman with the bird pendant was next to Debonkva. Do we know where Debonkva was? Not yet. No, Debonkva was on the far left. Okay, Debonkva was on the far left. And then the woman with the bird pendant was on the left. Woman with the bird pendant was on the left. Okay. Filling it in. God, we're so close. Okay. Bird pendant. One next to her said they were finer Debonkva, where she lived. So Lady Winslow showed off her prize woman, at which the lady from Karnaca scoffed, saying it was no match for her diamond. Fine, that doesn't tell us the position. Someone else carried a valuable ring, and when she saw it, the visitor from Baelton next to her almost spilled her neighbor's absinthe. So the woman with the ring was next to the woman from Baelton. Woman with the ring. Okay, the woman from Baelton was on the left. The woman in the ring has to be the one on the far left then. Puzzle solved. Okay. Alright, I think we got this. Alright. Okay, so from far left to right, Baroness Finch with the ring. Okay. The one on the left had the bird pendant. Okay, bird pendant. Lady Winslow, of course. No, actually, Lady Nassau was in the center with the diamond. Right was Conti with the snuff tin, okay. And then on the far right, Winslow. With the war medal. Ha ha! Oh boy.
We did it. Now to find Aramis Stilton.
So what I'm hoping is it just lets me back out. And I got that achievement. Eureka for 15 gamer score. So, yeah, I found one rune. Man, that took an hour? Oof. Jesus. Logic puzzles, people. Logic puzzles. I think where I got screwed up is when it said somebody next to somebody. Like, I got confused and I thought, like, I put in a word that actually wasn't there. So, I was like, oh yeah, just do that. But no, that's not how this works. So yes, you can solve the logic puzzle. It's a pain in the ass, but as long as you know positions, you can figure it out.
Time is an odd thing. Growing up, I was excited.
So what I'm going to do,
years might hold.
I'm going to skip this just because we're not actually going to be in this area yet. I'm actually going to turn right around. Can I go back to the Dust District? Is the Dust District still active is the other part. Because it might not be. So just to give you an idea of how I solved that puzzle, there is charts out there that you can just sort of fill in online, and that's what I pulled up. But basically how it works is there's a grid. It's a 5x5 grid, so 25 spots each, and you go by color, you go by location, you go by item, so whether they had a war medal, snuff tin, diamond ring, bird pendant, whatever, position. And then you go by drink. So that's One, two, three, four, five grids down, five grids across, and then you just sort of go down from there. So, for example, you have colors with the ladies, and then you have ladies with location, then you have ladies with their items, then you have ladies with position, then ladies with their drink. And then from there, you can also do drink with color, drink with location, drink with item, drink with position. And then you go another one on the right hand side, you go with position with color, position with location, position, that's it, with item. Then you go item with color, item with location, okay? And then you go at the very end, you go with location with color. And you should have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 15 different grids of 5 by 5. And then you just sort of go in between them. Okay, so now the district's just completely blocked off. Because there used to be a path over here, and that's gone now. Like, they did some lazy crap here. They did some really lazy shit with this. I don't know what they were thinking with this. Like, the door sealed, all that sort of bullshit is just like, alright. So, let's go ahead and load that save. We'll do it the other way. Because basically what happens is, there are two people in the city who have this just lock combination with them. And it's the two guys we were going to work with. But we got the achievement. We figured it out. Oh boy. I know that wasn't exciting to watch. I know it. But at the same time, if you want the achievement, there is a way to do it. You just have to fucking think it through. Like, just have a grid. Just have it ready to go. And when I put the video out, I might put the link to this grid. Alright, see, yeah, now the door's open. Again, what were they doing here? Because it's just lazy. Lazy.
Maybe I cut them both down. Howlers and Overseers.
Battle of Orban Rum for each Overseer mask. Oh wow, none of them reacted.
Hey, where did you go?
Look everywhere!
I'll kill you for that! My arm!
Alright, good enough. Not that it mattered, I just kind of wanted to get through. What was that?
Is he? No, you
can't be that hard to find this one loser. I'm gonna cut you into pieces.
And good day.
Cut you in half. Serves you right for killing one of mine.
Keep trying.
Oh, that's Paolo. Friend of mine. Well, okay. I didn't want to fight Paolo this early on. Sorry about that. All right. We'll head to the other district first. We can just walk through here after that. I was just trying to be a smartass, but, you know, we'll do that later. The other area I don't really care about. This one I kind of do. So we won't bother them. We'll just walk through and we have the thing we need. Yeah, so we'll ignore the left-hand side for now. We'll head to the right. I guess nowhere, but that was interesting. So one of the things I never figured out was how to get into this particular area over here, because I figured I could come back and figure it out, but like I saw before, you can't exactly do that.
Abello, are you sure you know what you're doing? I studied field. Brother Cardoza in the peninsula. The pirate crews there resort to these same.
Whoa. What was that?
Did you hear that?
Those pictures.
End it. So yeah, if you're looking for a no-powers run, this is your best path. But I don't really care. Not this time, anyway. Now, how on earth do I get in here?
And robbing black market shops. Help me find out who.
Oh, a combination lock. We'll have to remember that. Door's blocked. Okay. Is there a way to unblock it, is my question. Looking up. There's nothing there. There probably is a path up there. I'll just have to find it.
Can't be too cautious. What with the shops getting knocked off? No, no. This is what I have for upgrading your equipment. If only I could sell dust. I'd be able to. We could do business.
What else do you got? Dust out. Bolts, sleep darts, not really worried about those. Grenades, stun mines, spring razor. Do You have a map, which is nice.
I shouldn't deal with strangers.
So something to remember here is I want to try not to knock her out and take her out until I've done all my shopping requirements. So what I do want to do is try to get her lock combo. Wait. I wonder if this will work. If it does, I will be amazed. I'm a little perplexed, because I know there's got to be some way in there. Is there some ability I can get? Like, I feel like... Pass through rat tunnels, which lead into remote areas, also allows to bypass hostile encounters. Look, the window's right there. How the hell do I get in?
Don't know what I ate to deserve that.
Outsider's crooked cock!
Pissin' crackers.
Trick. There's normally an opening somewhere.
Anyone? Wanna buy one?
I heard the howlers have taken a robbing honest man. I never have thought. Sure. Miss that.
That's not it. These houses link up somehow? Is there an underground path?
Covering your face won't make the happy.
Let's see. Let's give him a little itch. I think you got a little bit stuck there, but that's okay. suppose this works if I can get in there. But I feel like this is just where I came from, and it really just is. Do I have to go up on the roof? Is that the trick? Motherfucker. I bet you it is. Come on, there we go.
Maybe I'll have a dentist in Dunwall rip the teeth from Delilah's mouth.
No more sleep darts for me. Oh. Well. I regen health from them anyway, so it's fine. No more solution. Well. That. Better go figure it out.
What was it?
Who is
hey, what?
You?
Good day.
I'll cure the world from the likes of you.
And good day.
Take back our streets from the Howling Gang. The following subordinate criminal organizations are hereby warned to leave Karnaca. And anyone professing membership is subject to imprisonment or death. The Grizzlers, the Hatchmen, the Mercurial Street Gang, the Champions, the Eyeless.
There's gotta be a way up there. Oh boy. All right. Let's do this. Come on. Gotta be like right there. How the hell do I get up there? Boy, those blood flies are going at it. Like, look at that over there. Like, right there. Where is this frickin' path? I I could always look it up, but I don't want to. I want to find it. I want to find the path. Gotta get into that locked room, but how do I do it? Okay, it doesn't seem to be anything in here, although I remember there being like a painting or something in here. Like, I see that, but that's not it. Like a hidden room, or... I guess they locked them off. Oop. Can I get to the top of that building? I guess that is the question. Maybe not like that. Nope, quarantined.
Huh. Someone's asking for trouble over there.
Intruder!
End of the road for you!
Let's see what you've got. Help her in sight! She can't just keep trying.
I'll perform rites over your corpse. Blasphemer.
Goodbye, no. Pupper.
No! 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 No!
A good day. Okay. Why is my verticality being taken away? Seriously, game. Damn rats.
By the
is someone there?
Is... Woman on
problem
the
solver.
You just destroyed a noble animal, butcher!
Down. You're so
hey, good. You!
A good day. Dog kennels. There's seriously no path up. Or is it one of those things where I have to find the damn door location somewhere else? Because this is... baffling. Baffling, to say the least. I bet you that's it, though. It's like, yeah, we got the shopkeeper's door locked somewhere. It's like, ah, fuck. Admitted everything at home at Armour Station on occasion, but died before revealing how he came in possession of Raindust Lock Combination. No further use of his possession has been passed to Vice Overseer Burn! Get out of here. He's an ugly dude. Nothing worse than feeling like you wasted your time doing something when the answer is somewhere else.
You're not supposed to.
I don't actually know that, but I just have a feeling.
What's that?
A good day.
Hello? Someone there? Hello? Anybody? Don't make me search the whole place. I don't have time for that.
Let's have a fair fight.
Yep, keep looking.
Anyone brought
them? Oh, there they are.
I know an agent of the outsider when I see one.
Brother, get ready! You aren't going anywhere!
Oh, wow, I died. Alright, that was way too quick. God, where are you gonna put me, game? Back out here for some reason. The worst. Like, I solved the puzzle, don't get me wrong. That's fine. Like, I could basically just go on if I wanted to, but I don't want to do that. What did that document say now? Before I get too distracted. Bring your own whiskey if you need it. Nice. It's like, need to make money?
Clive Silver's here, hasn't he? With me. He's upstairs now, so I assume we'll learn something before long.
Shit, what was that? One of us is down.
Keep
trying. Somebody's down.
No
your face, miscreant!
I smell heresy on
you.
And good day. Don't get me wrong, I like this game, but sometimes, oof.
Sisters. Strange.
Hang on just a second. The door's barred. Of course it is. Remove the door block from the outside, right? Oh my god, is it something stupid like throw a grenade? Yeah! Oh my god. Oh my god, I'm so dumb. Alright, well, I'll go back to that.
Draw strength from my brothers.
Like, I didn't even correlate that to the same door.
When I see one. End of the road for you. I'll cure the world.
Let's see what you've got.
So, that was the Vice Overseer. In case that wasn't obvious.
Damn you!
Ow. Don't infest my corpses, please. Thank you. Alright, we'll be back for burn here in a bit. That'll basically just let us run through the other territory without being disturbed. Oh yeah, he's very dead.
I wonder how the High Overseer is faring against Delilah back in Dunwall.
Overseer, Icarus Humphrey, Terrence Rios, Ty Abstano. Yeah.
Inscribed by the same hands that ended your miserable life.
What's Hello? Going on?
Brothers, over here! Defend yourself!
Keep striving!
Well, thank you. Thank you, gentlemen. You've been such wonderful help. See, this is the part of the game where I didn't give a fuck. Like, my stealth gameplay of this area was such a pain in the fucking ass. Oh. Alright. Pour some whiskey. I think there's some stuff upstairs, but I don't remember. I think it's like a painting. Anything around here of note. Just help this out a little bit. And what's down here? Probably nothing. But it was fun anyway. Is there a button? Can I open the door? Nope, not there. Yeah, so this is where the detainee was. Still dead. Hey! You little shits! Get out of here. Alright. Those blood flies do not like me. It's okay, I don't like them either. It's mutual. Anyway. If you're watching, having a good time, I appreciate it. If not, I'm sorry. I'm trying. But yeah, feel free to ask me questions if you have any. I've been through this game once already. No powers, full stealth. That one was not recorded, but if you want instructions on how to do it, I can help you out with that. If you don't care about the game at all, you're interested in other things, talk about plenty of things. Anime, games, YouTubers, whatever. Doesn't matter. Other Twitch players, you know. We could talk about Zeldathon, which is coming up just after Christmas, actually. It'll be the 26th. Not that I'm a part of it, but I do support it heavily, so... See, I walked in this room for this very reason, and I forgot to grab the damn thing. Blade Ballet. Let's see what this one is. Slight chance of eliminating the body? I don't really use the spring traps much, so it's not worth it for me. There we go, there's that lovely portrait.
I know you're all ready to begin. Our speaker tonight is none other than Aramis Stilton, who owns the mines where those you love toil beneath the ground. Mr. Stilton is known for his fairness, and that reputation is not for show. Welcome to the stage, a friend to the Miners Family Committee, Aramis Stilton.
Good workers, good people, thank you for having me. Our annual dinner is always a special time, and I cherish the conversations and the toasts as we renew our bond. My closest friend in this world, whose name some of you will no doubt guess, is known for this saying: we rise together with the same dawn. We feel the same wind on our faces. We fish the same ocean. These are words worth remembering, spoken by a man who fills my heart with joy. As you dine tonight, surrounded by your families and the other miners from your teams, let those words echo in your thoughts. And above all, please enjoy yourselves. You've all earned it.
Okay. Feel like... the rune is right here. Where are you? Ah, the room. Right. Hello. Ooh, money. Hey, open back up. And this is garbage. Okay, anything else in here? Doesn't seem to be. Raw whalebone, I'll take it. Actually, speaking of raw whalebone, let's go to Bone Charms real quick. sacrifice. No. No, not the rune. We want to sacrifice bone charms. There we go. The one I'm not using is that one. And I need one more. All right. Am I ever going to use Blade Ballet? No. But I will learn the trait. Let's just go ahead and craft another rune. All right, so if I go to powers, and if I look. Not stealthy, but that's fine. Well, that's the one I want. I want to be able to knock down doors without blowing them up. Contraband. I've acquired more forbidden articles from the street people nearby and have locked it away in the confiscation room. Okay. Was that most of it? Yes. Okay. So now... Someone's been attacked. You got it.
Get the cigars tomorrow. Wanna buy one?
Nah, not this time.
Are you up for a beer later?
You bet.
Holy shit!
Looky, so a person can't breathe.
The vice overseer himself.
Good work. Byrne was a tough prick.
Shit, whoever you are, I don't care.
Cool.
Outsider's balls. It's Byrne. He's dead.
Good work. Byrne was a tough prick.
Was Byrne a tough prick?
I've been trying to bring Byrne down for months. You did what others couldn't.
And now you own me, Paul.
We've been at war with the Abbey, not just over territory, but over the people of Karnaca as well. This is my home. And I'm going to send Byrne to Dunwall in a box to explain things to the High Overseer and the Empress herself. Bet you didn't see this coming, Vice Overseer. Now, what is it you want?
I need to get inside Aramis Stilton's house.
You're intriguing, and maybe more dangerous than most who darken my doorway.
I advise you to remember it.
Here's what you'll need to enter the house.
If you do have a hand in what comes next in Karnaca, I really hope you acquit yourself better than the Duke has.
You can count on that, friend. The Duke's a worthless buffoon.
Ooh. Now, just to let you know, that was basically easy mode, because getting rid of him is a lot easier than getting rid of Paolo.
The Duke, the Abbey, the Empress in Dunwall. None of them know what's best for Karnaca.
But you do.
I got the achievement.
Maybe you don't understand how things work down here. Things are changing. And if I have my way, I'll be guiding the course of the city for a long time to come.
That might be less fun than you imagine. What do you know about Aramis Stilton's house?
That's a bad place. You walk by some nights, you feel the hairs on your neck standing up. But they say Stilton was solid before whatever happened there. Good to the people working down in his mines.
What happened inside the house?
I just know the rumors. Batshit rich choffers had a party. Maybe something weirder. Before then, the Duke was just another aristocratic snot. After that night, he had a fire in him. A plan.
Can't steal from him, but that's fine.
Something.
Get lost.
You never tell me anything. Something's going on.
Can't you see I'm taking money? Okay.
Someone said you took out Byrne. If so, take his corpse to Paolo.
I did that. I think I got this guy's apartment key.
Even my toes. Maybe so.
So yeah, that's the other way, is I could just avoid helping either of them, just get the code from his office and then go that way. But that's fine. Diamond, war metal, snuff tin, ring, bird pendant. Let's see what that new bone charm's all about. Elixirs restore slightly more mana. Well, you know what to do with that.
Taking out overseers. We'll warm up to you just fine.
I'll take your money. Thank you.
Not a bad piece of work you did for us. But stay out of my way.
See, they're really starting to annoy me now. I kind of wanted to just kill them. So before I helped out Vice Overseer Byrne. What is with that? But this time I helped out Paolo. Not that I like Paolo, because I really don't. But it is easier than trying to fight Paolo, because you have to kill him twice. Which sucks. And I know it sucks. Because then you gotta find him twice. Then you gotta fight his whole damn gang. I got jumped and I'd be bleeding away in the void of a, and run like a rat. Face covered, non-overseer, not grand guard. Someone from out of town, I think someone good. All their troubles, and now some masked stranger from the across the water. Spread the word, Howler should be stiff for this one. Another painting.
Vera Moore. I remember that name.
I don't. Alright, outsider, say hello. I could leave nobody. That's a viable option. I'm actually fond of that plan. But I want to make sure I collect everything before I do that, because trying to kill and then run away and then kill again, oof. Too many blueprints. I don't think I've found a single one yet. Where the hell? I guess that's not my way up. Ricochet. Got it. I'm the cursed outsider. Woo, spooky. Tricky timing. What does that mean? Any grenades take slightly longer to explode. Eh. Let's go ahead and scrap that one. Confirm. But no, I do want to get up there. Question, does that window open? Nope. How about that one?
You can't take a hint, can you?
Is that not even here? I bet you that's not even here. I bet you I'm just, like, doing nothing for nothing.
Be careful. Look everywhere. Probably hiding somewhere.
This one's sneaky.
Oh boy. What is going on right now? Okay. Note to self, never take a nest keeper on head on. Something I learned today. Yeah! I was hoping to get Stilton's house done today too, but I don't know. At this point, running out of time, but I guess it doesn't matter. I could just go through it. It's not going to be like a simple hour thing though. It's going to be a long time coming. heavy pouch. Grab some muns, because we always need the muns. Question, did we get everything in here? And the answer is a hearty, I don't know. That. Now, see, there's that one. That one's the one I need. There.
Someone there.
Someone is asking for trouble over there. Noise.
Huh? You over here.
Oh, they really do want to fight, huh? Okay.
You won't get away!
No.
Shit!
Damn it.
This is bad!
I'm gonna cut you into pieces!
Oh, that was Mindy, huh? I didn't know that. Cool. Am I, though? Oh! You're gonna pull that shit on me, huh? Oh, thank you. Where's that gonna put me? Please don't put me too far away. I will be upset. I didn't want this section to be a two-parter, but it's really gonna look like it. It's really gonna be that case today. First terror, as long as it took me to solve that damn puzzle. Okay, good. That's not bad. That's not too bad.
There's a burglar around.
Where are you hiding?
Is there a burglar?
Did you hear that?
Hey! Hey! Knock it off. That one fucking bone charm, though, is going to drive me absolutely insane. It's right over there, but I have no idea how to get it. I figure it's out here somewhere.
Let me guess. That's her again.
Hey, you! Give us what you got!
Thank you.
Huh.
Silvergraph Studio Key. Well, I just take the window. Note to staff. Do not take any more Silvergraph from Miss Mindy Blanchard until she pays for what she owes. Do not let her pick up any of the existing portraits either. We do not offer credit, even howlers, and promise don't pay your wages. If she threatens one of you again, let me know. Bring the matter to Paolo. Kidding me. And you would think with me breaking the glass there, I could break it, but nope. Fuck. You! Underground dentistry work? Is that what was going on here? Is that bone charm? Boost adrenaline. Well, that's another one for the scrap pile. One of the whaling ship from Santiago Fisheries brought in a big fat one, bleeding all over the docks for a while because of an argument over port taxes. Need to go take a look one of these nights before it gets totally rotten and can possibly snatch a few gallons of blood to grease the fuel or to grease refill my ink stocks. Still, where is that Silverworks key? Was that something Mindy had? Seems like something Mindy would have.
If the Duke wasn't running the mines night and day, our children wouldn't be...
I can't
Why should I trust someone who hides their face?
You better run.
Nah, I ain't running. Why do none of you have keys? That's what I need. Somebody's got to have it, right? Silver Graph Studio Key. And who would have that key? Do you have that key? And done. Who's got my key? Do not tell me I have to go somewhere to find this goddamn key. I will beat you. Or at least tell me Paolo has it. Have I killed him yet? I don't know, I'm not sure. We're gonna save the game though, just in case. Hey, you're missing an arm. Yeah, that's a good thing I saved. It's a good thing I saved. All right. Yep. Restart from that last checkpoint. I just want to get through this section. That's all I want to do. I don't know why they were hiding 20 guys up on the second floor, but okay, fine. You do that. Yeah, what was that? Come take a look. Who was it? Come on. Come on.
Maybe there's a way to reach
doing?
Wow, they really fucked me up quick. Alright. Maybe I'm just gonna go with the gun. Maybe that's my better option. Just shoot him. Again, no, this is not my stealth playthrough. This is my high chaos playthrough, so it's fine. I can kill as many as I want. I could be sneaky, but it would take a lot longer. And let me tell you, a no powers, full stealth playthrough? Oh my god, that was a pain. Such a pain. I cannot tell you how much of a pain in the ass that was.
This one's carrying coin.
Cornered animal. Your attack damage is significantly increased when your health is low. Knockdowns much less likely to affect you. During melee combat, you're always knocks an enemy down. Take damage from him while parrying. Probably not a good idea to have those, but okay. Whoa! Dead. Yep. Okay. I know this was an alternative entry point, but I don't think it actually goes anywhere. Like, I can't get up there. It's like they thought about it and then just decided, nah. Let's go see our girl Mindy. Howler dead. There's Mindy. She's got nothing. Nobody's got a damn key. District. East of district, two guards. Guards down. Drop the root plane off the table. Disable the wall of light. as well as several documents and a bone charm. From here, retreat back towards the start of the mission. Durante's apartment. Okay, let's see if that's there. Could have sworn I checked there, but maybe I didn't. Ah, there it is. So, I bet you the Silvergraph's thing was like make a statue of them or something. Which would have been cool. Ooh, more blueprints. What's this say? Here's what I've been allowed to take from the saloon. There's an emergency stash. Hold on to it. Bring it to you two guys. Makes me sick to pay those bastards from the mining company, but we can't afford to let Paco and Bill die up here. Well, I don't think they made it. Yeah, this has to be something like taking their picture or something. Okay, so, we did all that. We have that one... No, we have a rune and a bone charm, so let's get the rune first. Buy what we can, get our upgrades, all that fun crap, and then rob the place. Because that's what we do. Rob the place. Thank you. Oh, there it is. My alternative way into Paolo's territory. Yeah, not as easy as you might think to get over there. Alright. So, most of our job is done here.
Not this time.
You wouldn't miss that. I heard the Howlers have taken a robbing honest men. I'd never have thought.
Look at all these blueprints. Piercing insult. Bolt can pierce multiple enemies, improve damage. Crossbow has perfect aim, even when you chain shots, improve damage.
War is scaring off customers.
Alright, let's get these upgrades.
I have some upgrade plans for your gear.
Yes. Yes, again. Yes, again.
I want to ask who you work for.
Yes.
All sides.
All right, got all the upgrades I want in this area.
I shouldn't deal with strangers.
Now we're going to rob the place blind. So we have to get to the door up on the second floor, but what I didn't realize when I did this the first time going through, that you can actually see in there. If I go over here, if I look right there, that's the door. I didn't know that was the door, but now I do. Believe it? Somebody's robbing these shops. I don't believe it. Again, how that woman even gets in this door is another baffling thought to me, but you know, whatever. Unconscious. Did he have too many drinks? What the hell? Oh, I think that's the paper, but for whatever reason, I can't grab it from this side, so fine. Unsent letter. Sweetheart, I'm still not sure when I'll be able to join you. I can't close up shop or leave my brother alone right now. Running black market business is every bit as tricky as I've always imagined. The conflict in the district shows no signs of abating. Day and night, we hear overseer gunshots and those screaming bolts used by the howlers. We stay inside, hoping all this will end soon. Whenever I feel sad, I look at our wedding Silvergraph. What a special day that was. I have an anniversary surprise for you, and I'm not sure I'll be able to wait to give it to you. Stay safe, my dear. I love you. Martha. Wed the month of rain, a love without refrain. Capturing special moments. The month of rain. Is that the trick to the damn door? How am I supposed to know that? When's the month of rain? It would be like a wedding anniversary or something. How am I supposed to know that? All right, hang on. All right, wait a minute. So month of rain. Oops, sorry, wrong one. A love without refrain. Rain is 15. 415? Is that it? Yes, it is. Okay. So, what do you got back here, woman? Hopefully not any blueprints. I think I got most of them. Reagent bottle. Why is there nothing back here? Like, it's just empty. Barren. Oh no, she died. What a horrible thing. Anyway, doesn't matter. I will take that map. Thank you. Take the bolts. Take the bullets. The grenade. The stun mine. Sticky grenade. Spring razor. And this thing. What is this? Relocation sickness? What? Witches sometimes stumble off balance after magical relocation. That's pretty cool. Take that new trait. Two more raw whalebone. Okay, fine. Anything else that I need? I don't think so. Fine. Have a good day. Yes, who is there? Who could that be? Nope. So this is the second time today we've solved this puzzle, but that's fine. First time we didn't have help. Snuff. The ring. Okay.
It worked. The information was correct.
Yeah, both sets. Well, all three sets, technically. So, man, that took a lot longer than it needed to. Zero alarms rung. Pretty good. And one fucking blueprint. Where the hell was the blueprint? I don't know. God, that's terrible. All right. Forget about coins. Like, that shit's everywhere. How would I know? How would I possibly know? So I'm going to let Emily say her piece. We'll save, and then we'll continue this on another time. And then tonight, I may do a special playthrough of a different game. It's been done before by many other YouTubers, and I'll explain it then. I'll explain it when I get to it, because I'm definitely going to do it, just because it's going to be like, oh my god, why aren't you scared, and you know, all that bullshit, and I'm just like, okay, well, let me explain, here's why. We didn't do too bad, though. I died a couple of times.
Growing up, I was excited about what the years might hold. About the Empire I'd someday rule. I recall childhood moments with my mother on her throne and my father, a figure of mystery. I remember the rat plague, my mother's murder, and all that happened at the Hound Pits pub. Now this. I just want to put an end to Delilah's life and get my father back. This house holds Delilah's secrets. She pulled herself up from tragedy, grabbing the Empire and changing it to her liking. With Duke Luca of Bell, she transformed a coddled dilettante into a schemer who helped her take my throne. She's made herself immortal, and even my father's sword couldn't stop her breath. I'm going to find out how she did these things. The next time someone shoves a sword through her heart, it'll be me, and I expect her to die.
Oh boy. So, now we're at the Aramis Stilton Manor.
I feel drained by this place.
So, yeah, we'll be doing a lot of this next time, because there's a lot of hidden puzzles and that sort of thing that I don't want to get into this time. Anyway, I appreciate it if you were watching and enjoying. Nobody was in chat, or at least not chatting. But if you were just watching, that's fine. I appreciate it. It means a lot to me. This will be up on my YouTube channel later today. If you have anything you want to discuss, feel free to leave me a comment. Can type in my chat, you know, all that fun stuff. I talk while I'm going along, so it's fine. If you have questions or concerns or things you want me to do in the game, I will try to take them into consideration. But for right now, I'm going to call this a session. And I'll probably be back later tonight, hopefully. It depends, because I do have my anime schedule that I like to keep, because there's my reviews, and I don't want them spoiled because somebody, you know, gave me information early, and a lot of things already have been spoiled for me for certain other long-term anime that have gone into postponed state just because they're writing the manga and they're finishing, and everybody's like, oh, here's what happened, and it's just like, no, please don't. And what I really want to see is, like, the anime just fuck everybody who read the manga over and then just, you know, do the exact opposite for the anime. Just be like, alright, here's the alternative version. But it's okay. Nothing this season has been affected. It's been, like, stuff from the past seasons that have been a thing I've enjoyed. And I'm just interested to see how they go. But anyway, thank you for watching. Again, feel free to like, comment, subscribe. It lets me know that you care. Lets me know that you want to see this continue. And your comments are something I do take to heart. So, like, if you have suggestions for things you want to play or anything like that, I'll try to put that in. I'll put that in my schedule. If it's like, hey, you want to play this game with me, I can do that too. Of course, I do a regular schedule, and if I'm working, obviously, I can't do that. But, you know, there's that. But nothing would make me happier than, like, doing something similar to this full-time if I could get away with it. But right now, it's not sustainable, and I'm not getting anything. You know, so, you know, it's not like I have subscribers or anything like that yet. But if I get enough followers, enough viewers going along, sure, we could do that. And on my YouTube channel, we are working our way up to 600 videos. And it's all of various different game types, not just this one. So, Dishonored 2 is just one of the more recent ones I'm doing. I do have to finish up my Dishonored 1 High Chaos playthrough. I already did my full stealth for that one. That one I did record, so you can see all that in its glory. And, yeah, we can go from there. So, again, I appreciate it, everybody. It means a lot. Really happy to be doing this game, just because I have fun with this game. I do. I do have a lot of fun with this game, even though this is only my second time going through it, and this time is with powers. The first time going through it was challenging, don't get me wrong, but at the same time, I wanted to keep tackling it and going through it. So, you know, it's one of those things where I got the pathing down, I got where all the bad locations are, all that fun sort of stuff. And now I can basically ignore that, use my magical abilities, and just slaughter everybody. So, again, if you want to see me use more abilities or specific abilities, I'll be happy to do that. Although, for the most part, I like to be up close and personal if I'm in a combat situation, just heads flying off, you know, cutting them in half, is all that fun stuff. But anyway, until next time, everybody, I appreciate it. Have a good day. Enjoy your time. Get something to eat. Take a rest. Go to the bathroom. Drink some water. All that fun stuff. And I will see you all next time. Bye-bye.